After successfully completing this lesson, you should be familiar with the procedure for discharging and be able to describe the tests required prior to startup. To gain maximum benefit from this lesson, you should successfully have completed the previous lessons. It is assumed that the hydraulic power packs have already been started. This lesson gives step-by-step instructions on how to start the pump. The practical section consists of two parts. First, there is a demonstration of the procedure. This is followed by an interactive guided walkthrough of the same procedure. Pumps are designed and fitted for the purpose of discharging the cargo. In order to achieve this in a safe and efficient manner, certain procedures and rules need to be followed, including operational checks prior to start of the system. These include pre-start checks, local startup at the top cover plate on deck, and remote startup in the cargo control room. You will now see a demonstration of the pre-start checks procedure. Click on the buttons in numerical order. Ensure that the service valves on the hydraulic supply line are open. In fact, these should only be closed when carrying out maintenance work on the pump or lines. Check that the level on the hydraulic tank is within recommended limits. Check that the hydraulic oil temperature is within recommended limits. Check that cooling water pump and the ventilation fan in the hydraulic room are running. Check that the pump controls are set at the minimum position. Communicate with shore to check they are ready to receive cargo and their valves are correctly set. This completes the demonstration of the pre-start checks procedure. Discharge can be controlled either locally at the pump itself or remotely from the cargo control room. Some vessels will have the pump and valve controls incorporated into a computerized cargo management system. The instructions relating to the specialized software should be followed where applicable. This training program concentrates on Framo equipment and does not cover such computerized systems. You will now see a demonstration of the procedure to be followed when starting the pump locally. Click on the buttons in numerical order. Check that the manifold valve is closed. Check that the cargo discharge valve is closed. Check that the local control valve is open by turning it fully counterclockwise. Push the pump control handle on the Framo control panel to the maximum position. Increase the hydraulic system pressure to approximately 150 bar. Start the cargo pump by closing the local control valve, turning it clockwise, and let it run with a hydraulic pressure of 40 to 50 bar for a minimum of 1 minute. Raise the hydraulic pressure to the pump by closing the local control valve further until the cargo discharge pressure is above the cargo manifold pressure, thus avoiding the possibility of backflow. Open the cargo discharge valve. Open the manifold valve. Raise the hydraulic pressure to the pump by closing the local control valve further, turning it clockwise, until the required discharge pressure or capacity is achieved. Remember to keep the system hydraulic pressure at a maximum of 20 bar above the hydraulic pressure at the pump. This completes the demonstration of the procedure to be followed when starting the pump locally. You will now see a demonstration of the procedure to be followed when starting the pump remotely. Click on the buttons in numerical order. Check that the manifold valve is closed. Check that the cargo pump discharge valve is closed. Check that the local control valve is closed by turning it fully clockwise. Increase the hydraulic system pressure to approximately 150 bar. Start the cargo pump from cargo control panel and let it run with a hydraulic pressure of 40 to 50 bar for a minimum of 1 minute. Raise the hydraulic pressure until the cargo discharge pressure is above the cargo manifold pressure, thus avoiding the possibility of backflow. Open the cargo pump discharge valve. Open the manifold valve. Raise the hydraulic pressure until the required discharge pressure or capacity is achieved. Remember to keep the system hydraulic pressure at a maximum of 20 bar above the hydraulic pressure at the pump. This completes the demonstration of the procedure to be followed when starting the pump remotely.